Hey YouTube, my name is Dan and this is a short free extract of my longer course called Animated Infographics and Data Visualization. That course, along with the free exercise files for this particular video and a free downloadable cheat sheet, can be found at bringyourownlaptop.com. Okay, in this tutorial, we're gonna look at overshooting the mark. You can see this one gets bigger, but then needs to get a little smaller and bigger again, little bounciness. We're gonna do it to this to learn, and then we're gonna jump to our value of sleep, okay? And we're gonna do it to our icon there as well. All right, let's go and learn how to overshoot. Okay, let's get something to overshoot. First of all, we're going to not work on this project, okay? We're going to actually work on a separate little job, and we can do it in its own little comp. The moment we have one composition, it's that little icon here, okay, and it's our comp that we see down the bottom here. You can have more than one comp, more than one page in a document. So new composition, so composition, new composition, give it a name. This one's going to be called Overshoot. It's going to be great, and we're going to make it, 5 seconds long, okay. Background color is going to be black, click OK. I show you this because I want you to know that you can have more than one comp in a project. Okay, so here's my handy dandy main comp, but I'm gonna work on this other project in here. It's like a separate little group. That's where we're gonna do our project. So what I'd like to do is let's jump into Illustrator. In Illustrator, let's go to open, and in your project exercise files, there's one called icon pop, and let's grab the animation overshoot, not offset. What are we doing in here? We're just practicing, okay, because I want this thing. I want to drag it into my library. If you can't see your libraries, go to Window, Libraries. Okay, drag it in. There's that part that I want to use in my animation. You can draw all of these in After Effects. It's just the tools aren't very good to do it. So everybody draws in Illustrator. Not everyone, but most people. Now, I don't want this big box. I just want the color from it. So remember, with it selected, little plus button, fill color. Thank you very much. Let's rebuild you now in After Effects. Okay, so that credit card is kind of like a separate little exercise. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna show you how to build another comp inside your project. Think of a comp as like a little group. You can see it down here, it's a little group of layers, but you can have more than one comp. So we're gonna go composition, new composition. We're gonna call this one overshoot. Make it about 5 seconds long, works for me. Background color we're not worried about. And what we're gonna do is put in a background color. Remember, it has to be a layer, new, solid. Color-wise, you might have to scroll up in your libraries to be able to see the colors at the top. Click the little eyedropper tool, click the blue, click OK. We've got a layer there. I'm gonna right-click it, give it a name, call it background. I'll lock it so we don't wreck it. I'm gonna zoom out a little bit. Actually, I'm gonna go to fit so we can see everything. I'm going to build the little compositions, the credit card thing goes there, the actual green credit card thing goes there. And what we'll do is we'll do a little scale overshoot, but you can do a slide-in overshoot, anything you like. Now there's two ways of doing it. We'll do it manually first, it's not that hard, but there is an automatic way afterwards. The only trouble is the automatic way doesn't work every time. So let's do it the manual way first, and then we'll look at automatic. Okay, so here we'll twirl down, we'll find transform, we'll do scale, turn the stopwatch on, make sure the playhead's at the beginning. Okay, and we're gonna set the scale down to 0. Okay, and then after some time, about that time, okay, mine's at 14 frames, I'm gonna scale it up to just past where we need it to be, so 120 maybe. Okay, maybe a little bit less, we're gonna have to play around with this. It really depends on your artwork. Okay, so then I want it to go back, kind of bounce back, not to 100%, but maybe 90, okay, back past where it should be. So you can kind of see what we're doing here. We're going overshoot, back, but we're overshooting back past where we need it to be, which is 100%. And then now I'm gonna go up to 105, and then one last one, which is going to be 100. Now we're gonna have to play around with the timings, and we're gonna have to add easing, because at the moment, you get a kind of a sense of what we're gonna do, right? So it's not that hard to do. We're gonna select them all, and go to keyframe velocity, okay, 75, 75. Okay, the only trouble with that is that it's quite intense, so what I might do is undo, and I say, remember, I never used Easy Ease. It's gonna work in this case. Works quite a bit with overshoot. Now, timing-wise, I'm selecting all these guys, and I'm just kinda creeping this in. trying to get my kind of idea of how the timing's going to work. You're going to have to play around with it yourself. What you can do though is say that it's all just happening too slowly. You can select all the keyframes instead of trying to like move them all along. Okay, you can select all your keyframes, grab the last one, well, not yet, hold in the Option key on a Mac or Alt key on a PC, and grab the last key frame and just drag it to the left. And you can see they kind of compress like a concertina, and it makes it heaps easier to reset the timing rather than trying to move them individually. So now it goes, whoa, okay, hold the last one, and now it's going to go, what? I'm not sure why I add the sound effects. Okay, so anyway, that is a manual way of doing overshoot. Same principle for moving it forward. Okay, go past where you want it to be, back a little bit, back a little bit, back a little bit. Eventually it rests in the middle. I'm gonna hit save, and this artwork here, I'm gonna right click it and give it a name. I'm gonna call this one manual overshoot, and we're gonna do an automatic one with an expression. So what I'd like to do is just turn the eyeball off on it, okay, and bring in artwork one again, okay. I could drag it in from here, or it's already over here in my files, artwork one, here you go. It's not in the exact same position, I know, I'm not worried. Okay, so to automatically do it, keyframe at the beginning, playhead at the beginning. I'm still gonna have to set the basic keyframes for this to work. So we're gonna twirl this down, and we're gonna go to transform. We're gonna go to scale. We're gonna start it at zero, and then after some time like this, we're going to, mine's at 16 frames, scale it up to 100%. So we have to do that, but that's all we have to do, no easing, no extra bumps. Now we need to add what's called an expression. Expression is what After Effects calls coding. Okay, we're not gonna get into too many expressions in this course, just the handy ones. Okay, and to set expressions, okay, first of all, we need to grab the code. I've already got it, it's in your exercise files. I didn't write it, I borrowed it from someone. And when I said borrowed it, I stole it, but it's okay, they said it's okay to steal. They put it up on the internet for people to share. So in your exercise files, there's one in here called expressions, and there's one in here called expression overshoot. Open it up, select all of the stuff that's in here, copy it. I've left all the credit for the people that did make it. Okay, and it's an edit of an edit of somebody else's edit, and they've got it pretty sweet now. So what you do is, over here, see the little stopwatch here? To get an expression applied to the scale here, you hold down the Alt key on a PC or the Option key on a Mac, click it once, everything goes red, okay, and that is the expression in here. So I wanna delete what's in there and paste that random stuff that we found, okay, and just click out anywhere else. So there's a big expression applied to this scale. Go back, be prepared. Okay, not that great. But if you tidy these up a little bit, it's starting to look pretty sweet, right? Now we're good. Cool, so that saves us having to try and time the bounce in and out. We just have to play around with how far these are apart. We don't have to play around with easing, okay? It's really handy. The only trouble is that it doesn't work every time. It works if you have two keyframes, but if you have to have a few different keyframes, say this credit card kind of moves up, then left, then right, and you want it to bounce, okay, it's not gonna work. It only works if there's only two keyframes. Okay, so we're gonna close this one down now and apply this to our original animation. This is just a little test case. Okay, so we're in this overshoot comp. I'm gonna close it down back to my main comp. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna apply it to this little bounce. Okay, it was looking cool without easing, but we're gonna go and replace it. Now, the one thing we need to do is, first of all, let's look at the icons for scaling. Okay, remember with the layer selected, click U. It's gonna show me my icons. It's not going to work because we've applied easing to it. Okay, so we need to remove this easing because it messes with our script or our expression. To get rid of them, the easiest way is to hold down Command key on a Mac and click them, or Control key on a PC. Just get them back to diamonds. Now we're gonna insert our expression. Okay, remember we hold down a key and click the stopwatch, and that key is called, that's right, Alt on a PC, Option on a Mac. Give it a click. In here, I'm gonna replace this, delete it, paste in our lovely expression, and then drag our timeline back and prepare ourselves for a little bit slow. You see it's going a little bit slow. Okay, so we're just gonna bring these two together. Oop, select just one of them, bring them together, and nice. You can decide on how far apart these are. Awesome. Now in this case, it's probably not appropriate to do it to the starburst because we don't want that to bounce back. We like it that to kind of just continue on and then stop. But that, my friends, is overshoot. But before we go, this has been annoying me. These need to be in there. You need to be in there. When you drag them out from the libraries is messy. You just kind of dumps them into your project window. Now that's tidy and I'm happy. Save, and let's move on to the next video. Hey there, what'd you think? If you liked the video, hit the like button, that'd be great. Also consider subscribing to my channel. Now this is a free part of a longer course. You can check that out on bringyourownlaptop.com. On that site is a free downloadable, printable PDF cheat sheet, okay, to help you with your infographics and data visualization. Also on that site is a bunch of other courses as well. So go check it out, bringyourownlaptop.com. Bye now.